In this video, I will demonstrate how by using remote.it, you can securely access and manage your Azure instances from anywhere, without being hindered by the limitations of IP restriction or exposed with open inbound ports. For this demo, I will be using a VM on Windows Server 2019 with an IIS web server installed. To start, I will demonstrate how you would typically connect remotely using Azure without remote.it. If you are already familiar with how Azure network rules work, and you would like to skip ahead to see how remote it works, you can jump to this timestamp in the video. Without remote.it, in order to connect remotely to an Azure instance, you normally configure the network rules of the server. First, you would add a rule for the remote desktop at port 3389. Next, you would add a rule for the web server at port 80. If you had SSL installed, you would typically have that at port 443 instead. Then you would copy the global IP address of the Windows Server VM, paste it into the browser, and the IIS web server default page would open. When connecting via remote desktop, you would again connect to the global IP address you copied earlier. As usual, authentication would require you to log into Windows, and the Windows Server would then be connected. Now, in order for the Windows Server to be easily identifiable for the sake of this demo, I am opening the system page and creating a text file. And saving it to my desktop. Without logging out, I am now closing the remote desktop. As I said before, when using remote.it, you can remotely connect without setting up any network rules or opening any ports. To demonstrate this, I will now delete the two rules I previously made for the remote desktop, port 3389, and the web server port 80. Deleting these network rules means the typical method of remote connection can no longer be used. Now, if I try to connect using the global IP address from earlier, I'm deleting the cache before trying to connect. A connection error will occur since the port is closed and can't be connected to. Likewise, if I try to connect to the remote desktop, I won't be able to. That is, unless I use remote.it. Since this Azure instance has been remote.it enabled, a secure peer-to-peer connection is possible from anywhere. The remote.it Windows app maps your secure remote connections to your computer's localhost addresses. The web service for this demo Azure instance has been mapped to localhost 33,000. Similarly, the remote.it Windows app has mapped the RDP connection to the Azure instance to localhost 33,001. Typing localhost 33,000 into the browser, like before, the web service default page will be displayed, where through remote.it, a secure tunnel has been created from your computer to the Azure instance. Typing localhost 33,001 into the remote desktop client, will connect to the same server through RDP. And all of this has been done without network rules, so the typical attack surface of using inbound ports has been eliminated. As an alternative to peer-to-peer connections, remote.it also provides proxy servers in case you don't have the remote.it app installed on your computer. To use a proxy server, you would first sign into the remote.it portal. I have already registered an account in advance. Windows servers that you've already registered will be listed. Then you would click the name of a device and its registered web service. Check the box to allow pop-ups. And you will be redirected to the web service default page we saw before. When trying to connect to the remote desktop, you would copy the displayed URL and port number, and paste it to connect to the remote desktop. Authentication will be required as usual. You will still be able to connect to the same server and access the same text file from earlier. As you can see, both with remote peer-to-peer and proxy connections, you can connect to your Azure instances without creating any network rules, opening any inbound ports, or using any global IP addresses.